day. The man's working his butt off out there. He's waving a two. Give him a wave back. It gets warm inside that cockpit. You start pushing your body. Access 79 positive. The negative G's, it heats you up quickly. Michael Wisk is a Lucas Oil Pitts aircraft. From your left, the beautiful, one of my books, probably the prettiest airplane ever built, the P-51 Mustang, being flown by Lotto Lennox this afternoon for us. I'm going to shut up and let you hear it. The P-51 Mustang went from drawing board to a flying prototype airplane in 113 days. It takes 113 days now to appoint a committee to think about designing something. 113 days. It came to be when the British needed some airplane to help them out. They could not produce the Spitfires and Hurricanes fast enough. They came over to have the P-40 built. The Republic said, we can't build enough for it. We're going to turn the plans over to North America and let North America build the P-40 for you. North America said, hey, we can build you a better plane than the P-40. 113 days, the airplane went from drawing board to sitting on a ramp waiting for an engine. The original engine, the P-51, was an Allison-powered engine of about 1,150 horsepower. Great performer at low altitude, sad performer at high altitude. They shoehorned in that Rolls-Royce Merlin V1710 engine in the front, cranking an SS of 1,500 horsepower, made it the stellar performer it was for, and is today, during World War II. Now this airplane was designed by guys sitting in white shirts, bow ties, number two lead pencils, and slide rolls. There were no computers.
Sure.
Yeah, I thought they got repainted.
They had to build the tooling, build the presses, design the airplane, put it on the ramp, test fly the airplane. The early P-51s had what they called a turtle deck. Was not the bubble canopy you see on this aircraft today. That was a later rendition, the P-51D model Mustang. You notice the scoop on the bottom side of the aircraft. That is the oil cooler and radiator for the aircraft. They found out there's a flapper inside that scoop. Control the airflow across the radiator. When they open that scoop and put the flapper down, the airflow through the radiator, they picked up about 5 miles an hour in cruise speed. That's a lot of horns, a big, nice, round barnstormer loop now. You put the G-loop on himself for a long period of time. It's about 3 G's right on the bottom side. Take the G-loop off himself and the aircraft for that now. There were more than 15,000 P-51s built during its production run. There are less than 100 flying in the world today. You've got two of them right here at the 2009 South Wisconsin Air Fest, and probably two of the prettiest you're going to find anywhere. My guess, Waddle-Lenny traces out of Super Air Street back at Air Show Center. Look, about 250 mile an hour right down there, just sitting line, easing back that stick. That's about a 350 point rose himself with right there. Nice big barrel roll by Lotto Lennox line. It's beautiful, P-51. Of course, they all named the airplane back then. This aircraft had painted up Boom Beam McSwine. The name of the aircraft on the cowling of the aircraft. Now the B-51 had a top speed of excess of 440 miles an hour. They could climb as much as 42,000 feet. And with drop tanks, it had more than a 2,300 mile range. You imagine sitting in the cockpit of the airplane for more than 10 hours on a mission. The Germans knew they had lost the war when they saw the B-51s flying high cover for the B-17s and B-24s. Demonstrates an 8-point hesitation roll in that beautiful P-51. one. It had six 50 caliber machine guns in the wings of the aircraft. It could carry a 2,000 pound bomb load or four rockets on the hard points of the wing of the aircraft. There were more than 5,000 B-51s destroyed in New York during World War II. You could buy a B-51 after World War II for about $2,500, maybe. Most sides were purchased with fuel of the tanks. That was 130-octane aviation fuel back then. You can't get that now if you couldn't afford it, you could get it. Today, a flying example like you see it here this afternoon, that's painted up in as good a condition as Vladek's aircraft is, million plus. It's over 150,000 just to overhaul the engine. Vladek's demonstrating probably one of the hardest aerobatic maneuvers to do, and that is the slow roll. You talk with any of the aerobatic pilots, I'm going to tell you that one of the hardest maneuvers is the super slow roll right down airshow center line. Trying to maintain heading, maintain altitude while rolling that airplane 360 degrees. If they scored a kill and came back over the field. Buzzed the field, pulled the nose up, rolled the airplane for the victory roll. Until the commanding officer said, hey, we don't want you doing that. If you don't know what happened to your aircraft, you could have a couple of shots in the back of the aircraft, damage a cable, and pick up the roll like that, you could crash the airplane right over the airport. So stop those victory rolls. They still did it. Get your cameras out, the father comes through. Last pass of beautiful P-51 Mustang, Moonbeam McSwine. Just a great sound. Yeah.